Don't be sorry. I'm going to do everything I can to get you full custody of your daughter.
Welcome to Ion Entertainment. I'm Donna Lee Heising, and today our guest is Marc Wasserman. He's a producer, an actor, and a lawyer. Okay, so tell us how you got started. I know you started acting at a very young age.
Yes, my parents threw me into a theater workshop at the local Jewish community center because they felt I was the ham of the family. and in fact, it scared me to death. I didn't want to go into the class. My father actually had to chase me around the building for about 10 minutes because I was terrified. I didn't want to go up in front of people and do anything. And they finally got me in there, and the little teacher that was there said, oh, come in, just sit and watch everybody. You don't have to do anything. This is what they're doing. They're learning monologues and reading from a script and going up, and everyone's taking their turn. Mm-hmm. And so I sat off in the corner and watched. I was in front of other people other than family. I was shy. And everybody finished, and the teacher said, well, Marc, go up and give it a try. And I did, went up there. I was mad at the teacher for saying that. I wanted to bolt. I wanted to leave, but I went up. It was some scene from Sweet Charity. And
at 10?
I was just reading whatever it was I was reading. I think it was an elevator scene, if I'm remembering right. But I did it, and couldn't stop me from wanting to go back week after week, and that led to summer stock and everything else from there with regards to acting.
Wow. Why did your parents think that you were a ham? What would you do at home?
I don't think it's what I did at home. It's what I would do outside, like at the store or at the temple. Mm-hmm. I was pretty famous for just kind of pulling my pants down and running down the aisles to if mom wasn't listening to me.
Oh, okay, so you're the most outgoing of the boys then, right? You've got two brothers.
Yes, I have two older brothers, and I'm probably a little less inhibited than they are.
Okay, so you went into summer stock, and then you got to high school. And what high school did you go to?
I went to Whitney High School in Cerritos, California. Mm-hmm. And it was a very unique school. In fact, now 25 some odd years later, there's a book called School of Dreams that was written about it, because every student that goes there typically goes on to a four-year college university. Like for instance, my graduating class had 100% matriculation into a four-year university. And wow. So at that high school, we didn't have any sports teams back then. It was all academic based. And we didn't have like a drama club or a drama class or anything like that. Mm-hmm. By the time I got to my senior year, after starting in seventh grade, was a seventh through 12th grade program. My senior year there, I was able to organize a drama club. They eventually have drama classes. We put on some productions. And now, 25 years later, they just got a multi-million dollar grant to do a whole media center and lab and all this stuff that they're adding on and gonna be building to that high school.
Oh my gosh, so, okay, well that high school should put a picture of you up for starting it then.
They should, you know? I think they should.
We'll
make sure I'm not
you?
Forgotten.
Okay.
They want money though. I'll give them some money when I can. I don't know when that'll be, but yeah.
Okay, so then I know that you got accepted into UC Irvine.
Correct.
And then what happened?
I was a theater arts major there, and 3 months into my first year, I came down with meningitis. Had to leave school. I almost died, and I was bedridden for about 4 months or so. And when I was ready to go back to school, I decided I didn't want to go back. I was very driven that anything could happen. I was only 18. I don't know how much time I have left. I mean, I really went overboard with it, but I wanted to be an actor, and that's all I wanted to do. And at that point, I was like, you know, I knew other people and other kids my age who were getting work and doing things, and they didn't have a degree. And so, you know what? Do that later. I'm going out to Hollywood, and I'm going to study out there. And you know, I studied with acting coaches from the Strasberg Institute and Stella Adler and the Meisner Technique. I just kind of dug into every little thing there was, because I didn't think there was any one particular way of acting or using any certain one technique. I kind of like to take a little from here and there and use it.
You'd already been trained too.
I had been working and studying for a while, so that's what led me to go out there.
Okay, and how did that go?
It went, you know, I mean, I pounded the pavement. I did lots of little shows here and there, you know, some spots here, some public service announcements, some episodic television shows, some B-movies, lots of theater, lots of the, you know, Actors Alley, little 50-seat houses, and lots of little theater and stuff like that. That's what I really loved, the theater and the musical theater stuff, so I did a lot of that. And
the musical theater, so you know how to sing?
I've sang.
Did you take voice lessons too?
I did. I studied. I had a voice coach for however long I did that, and always got musical training doing the musicals that I did all throughout the summer stock years, and Oliver and Barnum and Annie Get Your Gun, West Side Story, all those favorites, and they were really fun. I liked all that stuff.
So you met Ford six years ago.
Yeah, it's about 6 years ago.
Do you work with him exclusively now on his films?
When it comes to our production company, Race Ipsa Productions, since we've worked with him, when we have a script, he's going to be in charge of directing it or finding a director or shooting it or finding a DP, because I trust his eye and his vision out of anybody else I've ever worked with regards to my stuff. And then outside of that, you know, I've done acting jobs for him and several other directors and people that I've met along the way doing the film festivals over the last 5-6 years.
Well, you and Ford both have great personalities. You're so outgoing, and you're also very educated. I mean, you're a lawyer, and Ford is a professor, right?
Or he did the whole nine yards with the acting and his thesis and master's and all that. And he's a wealth of knowledge about anything, which is something I'm not. I couldn't sit here and say something and I can talk to you about that subject. He can talk about anything.
I bet you can, though.
He can. No. Really. Okay. I've been in places with him, and something comes up, whether it's political, religious, anything, and I'm like, how do you know that? Where did you learn that? How do you know that? He just seems to, you know, he's just a wealth of information, and he sponges things in. He's really great.
And so he's your best friend.
Yes.
And you've been a great friend to him. But first, I want to ask you about the film Falling Down.
That, you know, I'm glad you asked me, because I'm happy to announce that today, about 2 hours ago, I got a memo deal faxed over from a distributor who wants to distribute Falling Down. So we are about to sign a distribution deal for Falling Down. And that just happened today.
Well, congratulations, because I did an interview with Ford, and he was telling me about it. It sounds like a wonderful story, and it's a true story.
Yes.
So how did it come to be?
We had a mutual friend who had this great life. He had a great job, a wife, a young son, and everything was going, I mean, it couldn't be better. You know, it was like the American dream, so to speak, type of life, just nice house, picket fence, you know, very modest. And unfortunately, there was an accident with this man's son, his 3-year-old son, and he blamed himself, you know. The kid ran into the street, he wasn't watching him, got hit by a car. And he, you know, he went crazy for the most part, you know, over an extent, and over a long period of time in his life, I mean, you know, years, he started to develop a lot of mental problems, post-traumatic stress.
Yeah.
And his wife didn't want to have another kid. he wanted to. He wanted to replace what he lost. She didn't want to.
Why didn't she want to?
You know, she was grieving in her own way. I don't know. All that we know is that he started to become very violent. He raped his wife, trying to get that kid. He almost became, he did become a serial rapist.
Oh, no.
He wanted to have a kid. He was trying to get people pregnant. I mean, he really went crazy, you know. And we wrote a 7-page short film that we wanted to make to show him, you keep doing this, you know, this is how you're going to end up. Mm-hmm. You know, you need help. And he since got help, you know, after we did that. And after we did that, we felt there was more to explore in the whole scenario with this character and this situation. And we basically went out and just shot. And it was off of a 7-page treatment. Mm-hmm. And it just kind of organically grew, and with Ford directing, and we got a lot of great, great actors willing to really push the envelope. I mean, there's some very, very heavy, violent rape scenes, and, you know, some very dramatic scenes. And for the film, Ford made me gain 40 pounds to play the character.
Is that the real character? Is heavy?
Yeah. Well, he got. Oh. He at the beginning of the film, the character is in great shape. I mean, 6-pack, muscles, clean, gray, everything's fabulous. And then over a 10-year period after the incident with the son, his life, he's falling down. And when you pick back up, he's just completely let himself go.
Oh.
Big gray beard, hair's out, and he just doesn't care about anything. And so I gained 40 pounds to shoot that portion of it. And then when we finished that, I did the P90X.
Okay, I have that.
I did it. I did it for 90 days. I ate right. I did everything it said to do. I lost 45 pounds, was completely ripped up and in the best shape of my life. And then we shot the beginning of the movie. And it was a long journey. You know, in terms of getting ready and developing that character in and of itself, because just the physical transformation, the, you know, gaining, the losing it was easier, you know, because that was 90 days.
Oh, yeah.
And it was done, and I was done. But when I spent 6 months gaining weight and growing my hair and growing the beard and all that, you wake up in the morning and you see this. Who is that, you know?
There.
Or your wife wakes up in the middle of the night and goes, thank Ford for
the
best actor.
Oh, it's you. It's like, who are you, you know?
With that performance.
Oh, my God.
But that whole experience was great. And we did pretty well on the film festival circuit. We won some awards here.
Okay, well, I hope you start them soon. You're waiting until, I mean, Ford is recovering really quickly, so it should be soon, right?
Hopefully okay. Sooner than later.
Okay, well, thank you so much for joining us today. We hope that we've entertained you.
Thank you.
Ion Entertainment. Ion Entertainment.